Newtown, located near the Johannesburg city centre, originally started out as a racially mixed working-class district where bricks were manufactured. The Johannesburg Town Council bought land in the area at great cost and decided to name the district Newtown. A fresh produce market, a mill and an abattoir, as well as a power station were erected, and Newtown became not only a hub of agricultural trade, but also the producer of much of Johannesburg's power. A number of trendy cafes and bars, most notably the famous jazz club Kippies, also found a place in Newtown. At present, the Gauteng province is upgrading Newtown to attract more creative industries to the area. This development is part of a wider initiative by the Gauteng province to breathe life back into the inner city. New improvements include the construction of the Nelson Mandela off-ramp and the upgrading of Mary Fitzgerald Square.
We found a few artifacts in the site in about the first 2 meters of excavation, which is an ash layer that's come from when the area was burnt down about 100 years ago. The artifacts include things like glass bottles, pottery, a couple of plates, a few knives and forks, horseshoes is quite an item we find quite a lot. All of these items we're taking to the Museum Africa. They have an archaeologist that comes out to site to come and find what we're not finding, but we are helping where we can.
Hi, my name is Catherine James. I'm the curator of geology here at Museum Africa. I trained as an archaeologist at Fitz and I have an honours degree. The layers on the building site all date from possibly before about 1907. In 1907 there was a fire in the Brickfields area. They believed there was plague, so they burnt the area down. So most of the artifacts date from either that area or slightly above it or just slightly below it. So we're dating things from probably about 1900 to about 1912, 1911 is probably the latest date for some of those artifacts. So it gives you a link to the past. It makes you feel like these people were actually real people as opposed to just objects or items on a wall. So it makes you feel good.
This monumental project celebrates the past, captures the now, and embraces the future. What to some may appear as a hollow cavity in the heart of Newtown will in fact become the very pulse to breathe life back into Josie.